I bear witness that there is no God but one God, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Muhammad is his messenger, subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is a very important Quranic concept that the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam has to revisit and re-examine themselves versus that concept and try to improve itself against that concept. The concept of the one ummah, ummatan wahida, wa inna hadhi ummatukum ummatan wahidatan wa ana rabbukum fa'budun wa ana rabbukum fattaqun. Ummatan wahida, one ummah. What does it mean that the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is one ummah? It means a lot of things that we as an ummah are not doing. We as an ummah are divided along so many lines and are weak because of our division. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked us to be a one ummah so that we are strong, because an ummah that is united is stronger than an ummah that is divided. An ummah that has the same principles is much stronger and much more able to be at the forefront of humanity than an ummah which is divided along so many lines. We are a weak ummah because we are divided along these nationalities and races and schools of thought and madahib and tribes. And instead of us being a united ummah, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا, hold on, all of you, to the rope of Allah, حَبْلِلَّهِ, the rope of Allah, and do not be dispersed, do not be fragmented, do not be divided, the Quran says, وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا وَاذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ, and remember the blessing of Allah that He gave you that ummah. We are a divided ummah, and therefore we are not able to be witnesses over mankind. We have a function to be witnesses over others. What does it mean? For us to have the higher moral standard, so that when we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as humanity, we can tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we showed the others what does it mean to believe in Allah, and what does it mean to carry the moral code of the Sharia, and what does it mean to have these ethics that Islam is teaching us. But we are not carrying this responsibility. We are not witnessing anything over others. In fact, others are witnessing over us. Others are giving humanity examples of mercy, examples of organization, examples of strength, examples oftentimes of morality and ethics that we do not give, even though we have the responsibility to give this witnessing and to carry our duty as shuhada ala nas, to be the moral standard, the moral criteria in humanity should be the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And oftentimes we blame others for our problems, even though we are the problem of our problems. We are the cause of our issues as an ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and we blame others for our plight, but our plight is because of our divisions and our weaknesses. As we say in Arabic, نَعِيبُ زَمَانَنَا وَالْعَيْبُ فِينَا وَمَا لِزَمَانِنَا عَيْبٌ سِوَانَا. We blame our times for our problems, but we are the problems of our times. We have an issue because we are divided. Now, what does it mean to be one ummah? What does it mean to be united? Does it mean to be the same? Does it mean for everybody who is a follower of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam to have the same opinion about everything and to have the same language and the same culture and the same custom and eat the same and drink the same? No. To be united does not mean to be the same, but to be united is to have the same principles, even though the principles could manifest themselves in different opinions and different schools of thought and different cultures and different ways of doing things. To be united is to have the same base, but not necessarily the same building. Each of us could have a different floor in that building with a different color, and a different way of life. To be united is to have the same reference in Islam, but not necessarily what the reference means in the practical terms. And this requires some reflection here. Now, what does it mean to be united in terms of references? To be united in terms of references is for every Muslim and Muslimah to take the reference as the word of Allah and the sunnah of his messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Quran and sunnah should be the reference of every Muslim, black and white, north or south, Arab or non-Arab, or Western or Eastern, African or Asian. Everybody has to refer to the Quran and the sunnah of his messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But then when we refer to the Quran and the sunnah, we read them in different ways, in different places. There are parts of this ummah that are predominantly Maliki. There are parts that are predominantly Hanafi. There are parts that are predominantly Salafi, or any of these madhahib, any of these ways of looking at the Quran and Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There are people with different inclinations, and this is normal. This is not a division. The abnormal thing is to fight over these lines of division and to cause disputes because of our different opinions. As long as we have the same reference, the Quran and the Sunnah. Is it possible to have the same reference and different opinions? Yes. But why? Why do we have the same reference and different opinions? Because this is the nature of Islam itself. This is the nature of the revelation. The Arabic message that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibreel with to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam carries different interpretations, carries different ways of looking at things. And the opinions change with the change of time and circumstances, with the change of geography, with the change of customs. This is normal. But what is not normal is for us to fight over that, to divide ourselves over these lines. So yes, we can be united by taking the same reference, but not necessarily the same interpretation, not necessarily the same school. We should learn to live as Muslims, carrying different opinions and following different schools and different madhahib and different ways of looking at the same reference, at the Quran and Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.